heightened security. There was a march and a separate demonstration in Boston today. WBZ's Louisa Moeller is live in Roxbury this evening. And Louisa, the march was supposed to go to the State House, I understand, but organizers changed that plan because of the restrictions.
Yeah, Lisa, the plan changed, but the theme did not. Both rallies were about the enduring quest for racial justice.
They ran my son over. They ran him over. Google arguing while black.
Their voices rang out from truck beds and sunroofs, relatives of people injured or killed at the hands of police like Christopher Divins, Yuri Stamps, and Justin Root.
Execution in Chestnut Hill, unneeded, uncalled for.
Using Martin Luther King's own words to call for change.
Injustices anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.
Mass Action Against Police Brutality held a rally demanding the prosecution of police officers who have committed acts of violence. The timing in honor of revolutionary civil rights leader Dr. King.
What time is it?
Freedom wins it!
But organizer Brock Satter says he also hopes to send a message to the new president and his administration.
We don't look to Biden to be the restorer of order and democracy. I mean, he picked Marty Walsh for his labor secretary. We have many grievances with Marty Walsh.
They took their calls on the move, but the demand for civil rights didn't stop there. At a rally outside Madison Park High School, organizers argue Dr. King's message of change is more relevant than ever.
The main reason we're out here is for all the little black kids that are watching the news every day and wondering are they going to be next.
But amid protest and some pain, a sense of hope.
I believe this mass movement actually can mobilize more people than either party. That's what gives me hope. We've seen historic numbers come out.
Both rallies also aim to condemn the riot that took place at the U.S. Capitol on January 6th. Live in Boston, Louisa Moeller, WBZ News.